afternoon, as we celebrate the fourth Sunday in an ordinary time, let's all stand and join in singing our gathering song, number 611, All Creatures of Our God and King, number 611.
Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You were seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Grant us, Lord our God, that we may honor you with all our mind and love everyone in truth of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The word of the Lord came to me, saying, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I dedicated you. A prophet to the nations, I appointed you. But you gird your loins, stand up and tell them all that I command you. Be not crushed on their account, as though I would leave you crushed before them. For it is I this day who have made you a fortified city, a pillar of iron, a wall of brass against the whole land, against Judah's kings and princes, against its priests and people. They will fight against you, but not prevail over you, for I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord." The word of the Lord.
I will sing of your salvation. I will sing of your salvation. If you in you, Lord, I take refuge, let me never be put to shame. In your justice, rescue me, free me. Incline your ear to me and save me. I will sing of your salvation. Be my rock, my constant refuge, a mighty stronghold to save me. For you are my rock, my stronghold, my God, free me from the hand of the wicked. I will sing of your salvation. It is you, O Lord, who are my hope, my trust, O Lord, from my youth. On you I have learned from my birth. From my mother's womb you have been my help. I will sing of your salvation. My mouth will tell of your justice, and all the day long of your salvation. O God, you have taught me from my youth, and I proclaim your wonders still. I will sing of your salvation.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, brothers and sisters. Strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interest. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. If there are prophecies, they will be brought to nothing. If tongues, they will cease. If knowledge, it will be brought to nothing. For we know partially, and we prophesy partially. But when the perfect comes, the partial will pass away. When I was a child, I used to talk as a child, think as a child, reason as a child. When I became a man, I put aside childish things. At present, we see indistinctly as in a mirror, but then face to face. At present, I know partially. Then I shall know fully as I am fully known. So faith, hope, love remain, these three, but the greatest of these is love. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus began speaking in the synagogue, saying, "Today this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." And all spoke highly of him and were amazed at the gracious words that came from his mouth. They also asked, "Isn't this the son of Joseph?" He said to them, "Surely you will quote me this proverb, 'Physician, cure yourself, and say, do here in your native place the things that we heard were done in Capernaum.'" And he said, "Amen, I say to you, no prophet is accepted in his own native place. Indeed, I tell you, there were many widows in Israel in the days of Elijah, when the sky was closed for 3.5 years, and a severe famine spread over the entire land. It was to none of these that Elijah was sent, but only to a widow in Zarephath in the land of Sidon. Again, there were many lepers in Israel during the time of Elisha the prophet, yet not one of them was cleansed, but only Naaman the Syrian. When the people in the synagogue heard this, they were all filled with fury. They rose up, drove him out of the town, and led him to the brow of the hill on which their town had been built, to hurl him down headlong. But Jesus passed through the midst of them and went away." The Gospel of the Lord. I read of a story that Mother Teresa shared about a visit she and some sisters made to a gentleman in Australia. In her story, Mother Teresa recalls that the sisters went to visit a man who lived alone and who had no remaining family. She says that his house was in complete disarray and that he had fallen into a deep state of despair, tired of living and waiting for death. She goes on to recall that the sisters set about to clean the man's house and asked if they could light an old dusty lamp that they had found. The man told them no, stating, "For whom am I going to light the lamp? There is no light anymore in my life." Greatly disturbed by this, Mother Teresa promised the man that if they could finish cleaning and light the lamp, that the sisters would continue to visit him and would bring him the light of God's love. Several years later, Mother Teresa recalled a letter that she received from this same man, who wrote, "Dear Mother Teresa, I just want to tell you that the light you lit in my life is still burning." What a profound and beautiful example of the great need and desire of every human heart to love and to be loved by God. In our second reading today, we hear Paul writing to the church in Corinth about love. Much like the man in Mother Teresa's story, the Corinthians had fallen into disarray, and the darkness of confusion and depravity was overtaking the light of love that this young church had once knew. Paul writes his letter to, in a sense, clean their house and bring the light of Christ back to their lives. Picking up where our reading last week ended, Paul situates the many spiritual gifts bestowed by the Spirit in the overall context of love, particularly of the virtue of love or charity. He says, "If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. If I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing." Faith, hope, love remain, these three, but the greatest of these is love. I think if we all stop for a moment and ask ourselves, I think we could all agree that deep within each of us is this great desire to love and to be loved, to truly know and to experience the love of God in our lives in such a way that the darkness of a fallen world is overcome by the light of Christ, which never fades and is never overcome by darkness. St. Thomas beautifully writes that every virtue, including that of love, is found and exemplified in the cross of Christ Jesus. Thomas writes, "If you seek the example of love, greater love than this no man has than to lay down his life for his friends, such as man was Christ on the cross. Follow him who is the King of kings and the Lord of lords, in whom are hidden all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge." He goes on to reflect upon the cross, saying that upon the cross he, Christ, was stripped, mocked, spat upon, crowned with thorns, and given only vinegar and gall to drink. And why did Christ do this for us, Thomas asks, but to give for us an example of what it is to be loved by God and how in turn to show that love which we have first been shown. To love is to will or to fervently desire the good of another, that is to desire more than anything their union with the Father in heaven. Or as one homilist said, to love is to light the flame of life in another person. The fire of love that our Lord desires to bestow upon each one of us, that is each one of you, and that each of us are called to let burn brightly as a light in the lives of others, is none other than the divine love, the love of God that creates new life, that generates new hope, that brings the courage to stand as bold as lions. It is the love that bears all things, that believes all things, that hopes all things and endures all things. It is the love that never fails, and it is only found, my friends, in the cross of Christ Jesus. In coming to Jesus Christ crucified, it's only then that we are truly able to know and to experience the profound and ineffable love that the Father has for each one of us. It's through the cross that you learn the profound love that the Father has for you. And it is only through that same cross that we are then able to share that love with others. See, Mother Teresa and her sisters were only able to bring light to that man's life. It had nothing to do with the lamp. They were only able to bring the light to that man's life because of their own experience of being loved by God and their own fervent desire to quench the thirst of Christ on the cross as he called out, "I thirst." Brothers and sisters, perhaps you know someone like the man in the story. Perhaps you yourself come here today like the man in that story. But the more excellent way that St. Paul writes about is the way of love. And it's here that you find it. For it is here at the altar that you approach the cross of Christ Jesus, where the love and mercy of God flows as a never-ending wellspring of grace. My friends, as you approach him today, allow that love to enter into your life, into your heart, into your darkness, into your mess, so that each of you can too boldly proclaim, "The light in my life is still burning brightly, and the darkness has not overcome it." Together we stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With great confidence and trust in our Heavenly Father, we bring to him our needs, the needs of the church and of the whole world.
For the elect and candidates seeking to join the Catholic community of faith, that trusting in the truth of Christ, they may find freedom of mind and heart and preserve it always, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the safety of our military, police, firefighters, and healthcare workers, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Catholic education, that our Catholic schools may celebrate the richness of the Catholic faith that we have inherited, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all in need of forgiveness, reconciliation, or healing, may the Lord call them to repentance and bless them with healing. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, marked with the cross of faith, may they feast with the angels and saints in the presence of God the Father. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Sebastian Petrillo, for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And if you would join in praying our prayer for vocations found on the inside back cover of the blue hymnal. Almighty Father, you have created us for some definite purpose. Grant us the grace to know the path you have planned for us in this life, and to respond with a generous yes.
Yes.
Make our archdiocese, parishes, homes, and hearts fruitful ground for your gift of vocations. May our young people respond to your call with courage and zeal. Stir among our men a desire and a strength to be good and holy priests. Bless us with consecrated religious and those called to a chaste single life, permanent deacons and faithful husbands and wives who are a sign of Christ's love for his church. We commend our prayer of vocations to you, Father, through the intercession of Mary, our Mother, in the Holy Spirit, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Number 708, set your heart on the higher gifts. Number 708. That come from your Maker in heaven. These three gifts are all that remain: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest is love. If I speak with the tongues of the living and of angels, but speak without love, I am only brass without song, an empty noise on the wind. Set your heart on the higher gifts, on the things that come from your Maker in heaven. These three gifts are all that remain: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest is love.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. O Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of our service. Be pleased to receive them, we pray, and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exultation we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed
most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Dennis, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant, Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, Command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace in unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God,
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Number 695, you are near. Number 695.
Ways everlasting.
Let us pray. Nourished by these redeeming gifts, we pray, O Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, true faith may ever increase through Christ our Lord.
The topic for this Thursday's RCIA class is the Sacrament of Confession. All are welcome to attend. Please take a bulletin for information on the regional Winter Faith Formation Series beginning this Monday, January 31st, at St. William's, Pregnancy Center West Baby Bottle Campaign, and more. Next weekend will be Commitment Weekend for the annual Catholic Ministries Appeal. Please prayerfully consider supporting this vital appeal that helps to fund local ministries here in our Archdiocese. This weekend, we have the book Treasures of the Archdiocese of Cincinnati for sale in the vestibule. Books are $30. Stop by the vestibule after Mass to see the Marian artwork created by our students. And the February Lecture and Eucharistic Minister's schedule is ready to be picked up.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Number 766, City of God. Number 766.
The night into day.